Jerry 501. I am in Fukushima Diary, and this is an alert. The sudden blackout revealed the weakness of Fukushima Plant Reactor 4 has 4 days to go. In the evening of 3/18/2013, Fukushima Plant had the power blackout and the coolant system of Reactor 1, 3, and 4 lost. Power blackout in Fukushima Plant, coolant system of the pools and reactor 1, 3, and 4 lost. So what exactly happened? At 1857, the plant lost power. Even the seismic isolation building, where is the managing office of the entire plant, lost power temporarily. The reason of the blackout is not identified yet. TEPCO receives the power from Tohoku EPCO, but they can't send it to the spent fuel pools. So the system powers that are out is the Kurion, the cesium adsorption system, the coolant system of the spent fuel pool in reactor 1, 3, and 4, the coolant system of the common spent fuel pool. Then there are the systems that still have power, which is the reactor coolant system for 1, 2, and 3, the monitoring posts, the gas monitoring systems for reactor 1, 2, and 3, and the coolant system of the spent fuel in reactor 2. So what is the concern? According to TEPCO, the water temperature of the pool of reactor 4 was 25 degrees Celsius at 1600 as of 3/18/2013. It increases at 0.1 to 0.3 degrees Celsius. So it takes 4 days to reach 65 degrees centigrade, which is the safety regulation. However, the common pool also lost power, and it has 6,377 fuel assemblies. From the research of Fukushima Diary, the temperature increases the second fastest to follow reactor 4. TEPCO didn't announce how long it takes to reach the safety regulation. So this is just showing you where things are at right now on this graph. Japanese Meteorological Agency is giving the warnings of storm to Fukushima. The spent fuel pools of reactor 3 and 4 are still outside of the building, and they're expecting a storm. There is still no backup power for the spent fuel pools. TEPCO stated they reinforced the spent fuel pool of reactor 4. They said even if another earthquake of the same scale of 3/11 hit the plant, it can last, and they can prepare multiple powers to maintain the coolant system. However, as always, it turned out to be a lie. They didn't even need an earthquake to cause a power blackout for reactor 4. The power went down for nothing, and the reason is not even identified yet. Fukushima worker warns if reactor 4 has a fire, it would also cause explosion from 1 and 3 reactors. If the tsunami hits again, it could chop off all the power to all the lines, etc. Fukushima worker. Most of the workers know it takes over 40 years to decommission the Fukushima plant. Additionally, the tsunami embankment is still in the temporary state in the Fukushima plant. There's a photograph of it. TEPCO took 3 hours to announce they had a power blackout. Fukushima plant had a power blackout at around 1900, but they reported it at 2211. They state they took time to confirm the situation. Whether it was on purpose or not, they never update on time. If reactor 4 has an emergency, they would take even longer to confirm the situation. Probably we shall not trust them and collect information spontaneously. So please, if anybody knows anyone in Japan that has any access to any update information, please contact them immediately. Now, this is the information from Fukushima Diary. Then this is from NE News, and this was from CBC News at 1:18 p.m. ET. Workers at the tsunami-damaged Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant in Japan are trying to fix a crucial part of the plant that stopped working. Currently, the cooling systems in the fuel pools of reactor 1, 3, and 4 are not operational. Okay, so they're saying they should have a solution within a few days, and that the fuel rods stored in the pools will remain safe for at least 4 days without fresh cooling water. I'm not an expert on this, but that doesn't make any sense to me. I thought they had to have continuous water cooling. I don't know. So let me continue on, because this is a person who has a video, and I can't confirm this. Fukushima emission toward Tokyo area on 3/19/2013. So taking that date into consideration would mean that in the United States, it's still March 18th. So I would guess this information is coming from Japan. So let me just show you this plume. This is light blue is at 1500 meters, purple is 500 meters, and the pink is 10 meters. And there's no value as far as what this is. That's spewing. So I went on the live camera Fukushima, and what I thought was interesting is because since they're a day ahead of us time-wise, I thought I would look at these. Okay, so let me go back. So here we have the 15th, then we have the 18th, 3/18, and in this one, you can't see anything at all, nothing, you can't see anything, so everything for the 18th, you can't see anything. And then they go straight to the evening shot into the 19th. So if my suspicions are correct, let me back up here. If my suspicions are correct, then date-wise, we would be looking at the 16th or the 17th, because if they're a day ahead of us, then this probably actually happened on the 17th. So take a look at this. Here we have 3/15. Now, we have 3/18. And here, we have 3/5. So, they have taken the 16th and the 17th completely off from us being able to view it. And everything on the 18th is unviewable. So they threw this in, 3/5/2013. Why would they throw that in there? So, and here it says it was published on the 16th. And here it says 3/5/2013. And this here is the hour. So what is up with that? I'm sorry, I'm just very highly suspicious that there has been something going on for a couple of days, and that is why this plume map is available. Because there is something going on there, and we're not being told. So there's some heavy shit going down right now. So I'm sure we won't get any warning in Canada or the West Coast of the United States. Neither will Hawaii. So if you know anyone in Hawaii, please call them and give them a heads up. And as far as the West Coast goes, we've got a blanket of whiteout right now. So, you know, we can't even see the sun. We had a little bit yesterday, but the last couple days, here we go. Which is kind of interesting is that within the last couple of days, we've had super heavy chemtrailing. And the skies have just been soppy white or gray. So, yes, I will continue to be skeptical. And I just want to say, heads up, I have been wearing my mask lately when going out in public. And I suggest everybody drop your ego. If you've got to go out in public, wear a mask. If you've got to be outside, wear a mask. Don't go outside. If you get in the rain, go in, change your clothes immediately, take a hot shower, and just be smart, be safe. As always, I will continue to bring updates as they come to me. As always, God bless.